gets the blue envelope, which Jack leaves you with the yellow envelope. Would you like to swap any of the envelopes around?
Swap the yellow and the red, yeah.
Bugger. OK, do you think Wayne looks like a man who should be sitting at table one, two or three?
Two.
Go and sit at table number two, please, Wayne. What about Jack?
Three.
Go and sit at table number three. And Daniel, you have to go to table number one. You have the longest to walk. Thank you very much. Now, before they get too comfortable, do you want to switch them around, maybe change the men's order at all?
No.
Okay, then your job is done. Now, let me just confirm a couple of things. First of all, I chose you completely at random from tonight's audience.
Yes, you did.
You placed those meals, those plates down on the table in any order you wanted, and you could have changed your mind. Then you chose three random men from tonight's audience, and then you gave them an envelope, and you could have changed the order. In fact, you did. Then you sat them down in this order, and even when I asked you to change your mind if you wanted to, you said, no, you're happy with the order they're in.
Yes.
Your intuition led you to this point in time, and this is what it's all been about. Gentlemen, could I ask you to open your envelopes, please? Inside your envelopes, there'll be a message for each of you. I'm going to start off at table number one and ask you, please, Daniel, slowly and clearly to read your message.
A man by the name of Daniel will be asked to sit at table number one, where he will be served chicken tikka masala and pilau rice.
Well, hang on just a moment, because from all of these people, you did pick a man called Daniel, yeah, who's sitting at table number one. Let's see if you're served in the right meal. So you're at table number two. Would you please slowly and clearly read your message?
Wayne will be instructed to sit at table number two, where he'll be served burger and fries.
Well, again, Wayne is sitting at table number two, but has he got a burger and fries? Yes! Which leaves you at table number three. Would you please slowly and clearly read your message?
Which leaves Jack sitting at table number three, where he'll enjoy a pizza.
This is Jack, this is table number three, and this is a pizza!
Mr. Nick Einhorn, ladies and gentlemen. Wasn't that incredible?
Nick, remarkable. Wonderful stuff.
Hungry?
Well, I am a bit. I can smell the food. It smells good. That was remarkable. And I'm not particularly good with numbers. I can add up and stuff. But I know every time you add something and you give them a multiple choice or something, the permutations get bigger and bigger and bigger.
Absolutely.
So there were probably, if you think there were three initially you chose and then the three had the three envelopes.
At least 40 could, billion.
So there's dozens, if not hundreds, of permutations. That could have gone any which way.
Yes, it could.
Let's find out what Panatella thinks.
If we believe that your audience selection was really random, then it took a while to get the people up on stage. That time may not seem like much to a layperson, but to a magician, that seems like enough time for you to very clearly have in your head the people's names. And of course, you already know what the food is gonna be. And there's the three tables. And then she gave them the envelopes. Then you asked her if she wanted to change her mind. And she did. And then with things completely out of your hands, they switched the envelopes. The guys did, without you touching them. Then they walked over to the table and you gave them another chance to switch. And she didn't, but she could have. And then they opened up the envelopes and it had not just the food on it, but the names of the guys, which you knew, you asked them. But it was at the right table with the right food. And she switched them over here without you touching that to a lay person. That is a remarkable trick, wouldn't you agree?
Absolutely remarkable.
With very close to a century of combined knowledge of magic, Teller's huge magic library in Las Vegas.